हेलो फ्रेंड्स, होप यू आर ऑल सेफ एंड हेल्दी। वेलकम टू नॉलेज ट्रेजर चैनल। Let us talk about uniform and non-uniform acceleration. Consider a body is under acceleration. Now the question arises whether is it in uniform motion or non-uniform motion? Yes, obviously it is a non-uniform motion because uniform motion means constant velocity. But when a body accelerates means its velocity changing with the time, which means that an accelerated body is in non-uniform motion. Now we'll clear this uniform and non-uniform acceleration by taking an example. See here, you can see the changes in the velocity of a car in specific intervals of time are noted down in this table. Now, we'll analyze this graph. In this graph, x-axis is time, y-axis is velocity change. You can see the initial velocity of car is zero. After 5 seconds, the velocity changes 8 meter per second. After 10 seconds, the velocity changes 16 meter per second. After 15 seconds, the velocity changes 24 meter per second, and so on. So, can you see the velocity increases at 8 meter per second at every 5 seconds. That is, the acceleration of car is constant in this case because the change in the velocity is constant. For all uniformly accelerated motions, the velocity time graph is straight line. For non-uniform accelerated motion, it may take any shape depending on how the acceleration changes with the time. Now, let us see how to determine the distance covered by the car between the 10th and 20th second. In this case, velocity is not constant. Velocity of the car is not constant, but is continuously changing because of uniform acceleration. Here, the velocity change of a car at 10 seconds is 16 meter per second. Velocity change of the car at 20th second is 32 meter per second. Therefore, the average velocity of the car is equal to 32 plus 16 divided by 2. That is equal to 24 meter per second. The time interval is 20 minus 10. T2 minus T1, that is 20 minus 10 is equal to 10 second. Therefore, the distance covered is equal to 24 meter per second into 10 second is equal to 240 meter. As in the earlier example, also we can calculate the distance covered by the car, that is area of quadrangle ABCD. Area of quadrangle ABCD is equal to area of quadrangle AECD plus area of triangle ABE. Here, area of AECD is equal to AD into DC. That is, what is AD? AD is 60 into DC is 10. 60 into 10. That is 160. Now, area of triangle ABE is equal to, what is the formula for area of the triangle? Half into base into height. What is the base here? AE. Height is BE. So, half into, what is the base? AE, that is 10. Half into 10 into BE. What is BE? 60. That is 160 divided by 2 is equal to 80. Now, area of quadrangle ABCD is equal to area of AECD. That is 160 plus area of triangle ABE, that is 80, is equal to 240. So, the distance covered is 240 meter. You can see the answer is C.
So, friends, I hope tumhala ha video avadla asel. Tar nakkis video la like kara, share kara. आणि त्याचबरोबर चॅनेलला सबस्क्राईब करा आणि बेल आयकॉनला क्लिक करा, म्हणजे जेव्हा जेव्हा मी ह्यासारखे नवनवीन व्हिडिओ अपलोड करेन तेव्हा तुम्हाला त्याचं नोटिफिकेशन मिळत राहील. आणि त्याचबरोबर खाली कमेंट करायला विसरू नका. फ्रेंड्स, तुम्हाला तर माहितीच आहे ह्या चॅनेलवरती 10th स्टँडर्डचे सर्व व्हिडिओज अवेलेबल आहे. आणि हे सगळे व्हिडिओ पाहण्यासाठी डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्समधील जे लिंक आहे त्याचा यूज तुम्ही करू शकतात किंवा मित्रमैत्रिणींनासुद्धा देऊ शकतात. सो फ्रेंड्स, आय होप की हे सगळे व्हिडिओज तुम्हाला हेल्पफुल आहे, यूजफुल आहे. सो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस कन्क्लूड ऑन टुडेज टॉपिक. विल मीट ऑन नेक्स्ट व्हिडिओ विद ए न्यू व्हिडिओ विद ए न्यू टॉपिक. Thank you for watching this video. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.